Mukta is a Libre open source font. When we sort of take up type design assignments, there are different kinds of roles and goals which one can take. And certain people look at type design as a functional requirement, as an aesthetic requirement, and so on and so forth. And one of the things which I tried to look at or tried to achieve via font design is I tried to design a font in response to a question. Okay, and the question which I've often repeated in multiple forums is how do we match multiple scripts? And this is a significantly old question. I mean, we've been having multilingual, multi-script printing and typography for a very long time. Ever since we've been printing books, multiple scripts have coexisted on a single page, and different people have used different approaches. Okay, and each of these approaches have certain advantages and disadvantages. When it comes to Indian scripts, okay, the best we can get as of now, or the best that we got for a very long time was something like this. Okay, you would have a traditional Devanagari, okay, which would be matched along with Times New Roman, or you would have a monolinear humanist Devanagari, which would be matched along with Helvetica. Okay, and people would not be, and they wouldn't bat an eye at this approach. The other approach, okay, which I was equally disconcerted about, and was the fact that there was always this Latin god, there was this Latin typeface which was reference. So what you would do is you would first select the English typeface. It's Bodoni, okay, and then you say, okay, now let's adapt our script to Bodoni. Okay, and let's see how we can get it. So what would happen is that Latin would get a certain preference, and then the Devanagari or any other regional script would then be derived from it. Okay, and there are peculiarly difficult problems that one encounters. So our scripts are far more complex in terms of morphological features, and so certain features have to be completely reimagined or reinterpreted. Okay, and then there are questions about ethics and originality and so on and so forth. And so in response to this, what we tried to do is we tried to design a typeface without having a reference. So we'll build a typeface ground up such that we don't give preference to one script. Okay, we try and design a typeface where we, in some sense, make sure that one script does not dominate over the others. The history is fairly long. The earlier type family which we designed was called Ferrani, and we later expanded that family because it's a 10-minute presentation. I'm quickly going to run through it. But what we essentially did is for the Devanagari, so it's a humanist monolinear typeface, and we maintain or we sort of stay faithful to each of their script traditions. So the Latin has a left inclined axis, the Devanagari has a slightly right inclined axis. So we don't even match the axes. And so we go with the eye, we went with the eye. The only kind of matching that we did was with respect to the heights. Okay, and here a bit more optical correction was required. So usually, because Latin is not as complex as Devanagari and our scripts, when you sort of fix Latin with Devanagari, the Latin looks larger. Okay, and the Devanagari tends to look smaller. Okay, and then people can read it in different ways, and we wouldn't want that kind of a reading, and so we would want them to somewhere look equal, and so we spent a fair bit of time trying to understand how do you sort of match the heights. Okay, this in terms of visual features, what we tried to do is we in some sense tried to have some sort of a similar grammar, that is we sort of kept the modulation similar. Okay, but because the Devanagari tends to get a little more complex, one has to modulate it a slightly little more. We kept the apertures somewhat similar, but because Devanagari, if you keep them that open, they look really open. You add the extra sweetness to the letter by just bringing them in. Traps were somewhat similar, and we try to sort of match the terminal. So it's not like we have extremely different visual features. While we were matching features, we also sort of tried to be faithful to what we call as a script-specific grammar. Okay, what we often see in Devanagari typefaces which are derived from Latin is if you have a letter such as D, okay, what people do is they take the letter S and they sort of put a stick on top of it. Okay, the letter O is essentially the number 3 with a horizontal line on the number 1. So you sort of, you know, so you sort of dissect a Latin typeface. Okay, you pull out the horizontals, verticals, you pull out the things, and you sort of stick them all together. This for me is somewhat unnerving. To me, typefaces which were built like this, they looked like Frankensteinian monsters. They look like creatures which are created by stitching dead parts together. And it's easy for type designers to be critical. I mean, we all are, you know, we have sensitive eyes and we all can sit on the wings and criticize. But as a very famous teacher said, see, it's easy to criticize. If you want to respond, make a typeface, okay? And show others how it is done, okay? And there's a lot of value in that. And I mean, it's very easy to criticize. And so, and when one starts doing it, one understands the great difficulty that one has to go through. Okay, because you try and adjust something else pops up. And you try and fix something else, and then it starts looking good. But this is what we tried to do. And if you look at the letters, okay, so you see that the D is very different than the Latin S. Okay, in fact, the Gujarati K and the D are quite different than the Latin S and the Devanagari D. And so we've tried to maintain what we call a script-specific grammar. Okay, that's the kind of a gray we get. The earlier slide was on white, but I was extremely skeptical of the projector because it was very white, so I sort of reversed that. We didn't work too much on the gray, I must say. So we can achieve what we call as perfect gray. You can have letters with almost equal gray, but what you end up doing is you end up spreading the letters. So if you're working with Devanagari and you want Devanagari to match completely with your Latin, you have to make it wide. So you open it up, you make it wide, you sort of reduce its complexity so that the counters sort of come up. So we didn't spread our letters too wide, and we sort of get an okayish kind of a grip. Okay, then comes the fun part, which is adding the weights. Okay, if you work with Latin, so Latin in that sense is somewhat easier to do. Because when you have a J and you make an extra bold of it. It's really, really hard. And then we have even more complex scripts. So we have Bangla and Odia, and we have conjuncts which you want to make extra bold. It takes a fair amount of work to get them bold and sort of to match the bold across all scripts. So that's the 7 weights. So these are the 7 weights that are available. And I'm very proud to say that probably this is the only open source font. In fact, it's probably the only font which has around 7 weights, and probably the only open source font which gives the 7 weights. This is important because as of now, Devanagari typography was imagined only in 2 weights, regular and bold. And in most cases, the bold was sort of an interpolated bold, or rather an extrapolated bold. And in order to have a very nice light, which all of us really like for the fancy greeting cards and so on and so forth, so we sort of worked on that. So we moved from extra light to extra bold. So these are the sort of 7 weights we designed. That's the entire gift set. Some nice things which we did is the fact that we added some open type features. Okay, so in Devanagari we have these standard fights. Okay, we have 2 kinds of lures. Okay, and 2 kinds of shows. So there's a Hindi show and there's a Hindi lure. There's a Hindi 5-8 and there's a Marathi 5-8. And what happens is in current fonts, in most fonts, you don't get this alternative. Okay, so a lot of people just provide 1 default font, and we've sort of incorporated this into our fonts. And so let me just give you a demo over here. So all of these features are available on the web. So this I'm pulling this directly from Google. So this is a font. This is a web page. Okay, And so one of the things which we lament and we all love to criticize is the fact that, you know, if you look at Indian language websites and you look at our newspapers and you sort of compare them to other newspapers, you say our websites are not quite there. And you sort of feel that the aesthetic is somewhat dated or is not quite contemporary. And one reason for that is the lack of the availability of good fonts. And so I also wanted to sort of create a demo page to show what all is possible. And so you would see, so this is a presentation which is made on the web. So here are all the conjuncts which are available. Okay, and here I'm on the browser. I'm using all the open type features. So the first kukka is a horizontal kukka. And then you have the stacked one, okay? So on the fly, I'm switching the, so the text is coherent in Unicode, but I can choose a style, okay? Based on what kind of a style we want. And this is not only for this, what we can, you can also do, so these are just CSS effects which you can add. Okay, so here you can see, on the fly I'm able to change the style. So you no longer have to fight about the fact that this is a Marathi show and this is a Hindi show, or this is a Hindi line, or rather this font is a Marathi font and this font is a Hindi font. And so not only we have this, but we also have stylistic alternatives. So this is supported at the moment by only Chrome. So Firefox does have the contextual alternative and the stylistic alternative feature, but it's not all that well implemented. And Intic scripts are, so they are the last to karne ke liye. But I'm quite happy that we've been able to do this in a browser. Another feature that we sort of worked on is the sort of sticking matras. So one of the things which we used to complain about when we were students and used to sit in the wings is that our matras used to hang. So it's a relic of the hot metal printing days, because there are these metal pieces, so the matra never used to actually stick. Whereas in calligraphy, you sort of try and stick the matra. And what happened is the later type designers sort of used the hanging matra as a reference, okay? Primarily because you would have to reduce the number of matras. And we didn't want that. We thought we would like to have the matra to go all the way. So no matter how big your conjunct, okay, so if you take a word such as cursa perla, which is a fairly red conjunct, comes in the word explicit, the matra would traverse over all the letters and will hit the shiro. This is how the font looks, okay? In the end, here are some characters, and well, this is how it looks. It has a matching Latin. The font is a Libre font. It's a free and open source font, which means you are free to use it. More importantly, you are free to modify it. You are free to add to it. You can do whatever is it that you want with it, okay? So that's the first part, okay? So this, the font is released at around a year or so, okay? It's fairly popular, okay? And now I teach type design, so I have a bunch of students with whom I share this and many other processes. And being a teacher is far more scarier than what most people think. So the kind of questions that I get asked around are as follows, you know. So how does, you know, me being able to identify Helvetica from Helvetica Noi help me achieve my life goals? Okay. Do you think we can change society through kerning? Okay. Why is it that you're making us do all of these stupid assignments? Okay. So a common question which people ask is, how long, Girish, did it take to do this font? So it was not me, it was a whole team. So there was me and Yashodeep. So both of us designed the font, and there was a fairly large village which sort of helped us test and do it. But the approximate answer is 3 years. And so most students ask, is it worth it? You know, spend like 3 years to do all of this, when we somewhere at the back of the mind know that most people don't even look at the kind of font that is there. Okay, you know, if the knot is big or if the ka is here or there, people can read it, because the human mind has this ability to look over all the, you know, all the stupid things that are there. All that they want is just the content. So how do I, you know, share or communicate the value that I've received from this? And there are multiple ways that we can answer this, okay? The first answer is a very managerial, government, bureaucratic answer, and that is you sort of show downloads, okay? I can show that on a month, so if you're an engineer or business person, you show that. So 31 lakh people use the font on a week, or those are the number of views that we get on a week, or these are the number of people that download it, or something of that sort. Okay, but I don't think that's the only way by which we can measure value. Okay, another way by which you can measure value is this book. So there's an organization called Pratham, okay, and they essentially write tribal stories. Okay, they get it translated and they give out books. So in a country such as ours, okay, where people don't have food to eat, where students don't have money to buy textbooks, it is ridiculous to expect anyone to buy fonts, okay, to, you know, set whatever. So, but on the other hand, when I've made it a Libre font, okay, it's a free font, and I give it to an organization, and the organization uses it, and this sort of reduces the cost of the book, and the book is given to all the tribal kids, and it goes all the place, there's a certain joy that I feel, ki chalo, kuch to kiya hai. Okay. Another thing which I felt, and here's a map, okay, so this was used by them, and this is something fun which happens. So these are some experiences as a font designer. So there are certain experiences which only a font designer feels, okay? A font designer, so part of the joy or the sadness of a type designer is that you actually have no control over how your font is going to be used, okay? So you see your font being used in the most horriblest way possible. Okay, and there is nothing you can do about. Okay, the other thing is you get religious, you get what you call politically associated with people who use your font. Okay, so this font was used by MNS, the Maharashtra Navnirman Sena. Okay, for their election campaign. Okay, and so I got phone calls by from people saying that, Girish, have you joined the MNS? I did not know of your police. So thankfully the same font was used by the Shiv Sena. So then I sent. So I send another copy saying, since we don't istemal kar. But another joy that I have, or part of our education, or part of the hegemony of the Latin script, has seeped into our education. So you would see we so as our students, we were not our students are unable to do many Devanagari or Gujarati type assignments because there aren't fonts available. Now that we've made these fonts available, it's possible to give students these assignments, to give them these fonts and say, you know, chalo ab layout karo. Okay, so that is one joy. Affiliations have gone a little higher, and so I don't know why this font has become so political. So I was extremely, you know, surprised to find that the finance minister used this. So this is Sabka Budget. So the finance minister used our font for presenting this year's budget. So for some strange reason, we've become more and more, only Sarkari people seem to be liking our font. Okay, these again are very utilitarian, what do you call, ways of giving value. Okay, there is another very personal value which I received. Okay, so those of you who know IDC, and those of you who know Professor Sri Kumar and me, so that as young students, we used to go on walks, you know, Hiranandani and so on, and when we would go on walks, okay, you would find an interesting typeface, and then you would sit and look at it for hours and say, oh, this is this, and you would say, this is probably Perpetua, iska R alag hai, yeah, something of that sort, and there's a certain joy in that, okay, and what has happened to me now, there's a specific joy that I rediscovered, which is when I was sort of going, and then I would see a hoarding, and I would say, that looks familiar. And when I would go in closer, I would see it would be my font. and people would say, I wish it kaafi achha lag raha hai. So if you say, Girish, what is it that you're trying to achieve with your children or with your students? It is this, that I would want them to experience this joy, you know, to go out. And I know. Okay, yeah, so time is up, so I'll quickly show you another thing, okay, which we've been working on, okay, and that is this tool. So part of my PhD, so one complaint which a lot of people have is that we don't know how to find Devanagari fonts and so on and so forth, so at DSource, we've sort of built a tool, okay, so this is a Devanagari search tool. What the tool does, there'll be no video probably, but you would probably be able to see it. Okay, so what the tool essentially does is it has a set of morphological, okay, so this, I'm going to fast forward. How big is the video? Okay, so around 3 minutes. Yeah, so essentially it's a search tool. So there are similar tools which are available for Latin, but there was no such tool for Devanagari. So what the tool has is, it has a set of features. So you can select the kind of tool that you want. Okay, you can select, let's say, a particular gray value. Okay, you can select contrast and so on and so forth, and axis and vertical terminal and so on and so forth. So there's a whole bunch of properties which are there. Okay, yeah, and so once you've sort of selected one of these parameters, okay, you go on to then say, okay, so they're explaining this. Okay, this is the final one. Okay, so once you select the parameters, you click fonts. Okay, and what it does is it sort of shows all the fonts which are there. So if you're looking for a monolinear font which is dark, then it will show all the fonts. Okay, what I've also done is, and so what happens in most cases is a lot of students don't know who the type designers are. So there's a wonderful font over there called Prakash, okay, and it's designed by Rajiv Prakash. So not many people know that. Okay, and so what tends to happen in our education is only Latin type designers get celebrated, and primarily because our type designers don't like, they really don't come up. So then during my PhD, I had collected a whole bunch of fonts. I had this entire resource of fonts. I found out the type designers, and I sort of put them in this database. The database is still being built, okay? And so yeah, so you sort of put in these morphological features, yeah, and then there's parts about the Devanagari terminology. Okay, I'll just quickly show you the tool. Okay, so there's the tool. Okay, so this is the simple tool. So this is the hand. So this is the facet. So let's say you want traditional Devanagari, or this is monolinear. Then you click this. You come over here and you say click font. Oh, okay. Yeah. But yeah. So that's the tool. The terminology contains all of this. So for someone who doesn't know what a vertical terminal is, you can go to terminology and they'll find that out. What I've also put is a whole bunch of resources. So books and references. So a lot of people don't find books and references for our scripts. And so all the material which I collected during my thesis is available over here. So anyone who's interested can please use that. Okay. Thank you so much.